And we have investigative reporter Paul Van Osdol. He's been working this story, trying to get us some more information about the suspect. Paul joins us now live on the phone. Paul, I know you've been spending a lot of your morning in the neighborhood where the suspect lived. What can you tell us at this point?
Well, Janelle, I can tell you that we spent the last several hours here in this neighborhood, and let me describe it for you. It's a very quiet neighborhood in Murraysville. The suspect and his family live on a cul-de-sac. Neighbors have told me throughout the morning that this is a good family. There were no signs of trouble. They would see the suspect out playing in the street or in the neighborhood, and he also has, I believe, an older brother who also goes to Franklin Regional. And again, they've known these folks for years, and no signs of any problems. So as you can imagine, everybody around here is just simply shocked to have heard what happened.
I would see him go into the park that's part of the neighborhood and playing hockey and everything, and just getting on the bus and every other kid in the neighborhood.
And that was a neighbor who lives right next door to the suspect's family talking about him. Another interesting note, the assistant principal who may have saved the day here by tackling the suspect lives literally just down the street from him, less than the length of a football field away from the suspect's house. And he has also lived here for some years, and the neighbors know him and say very good things about him as well. Now, there has been a police presence in front of the suspect's house all morning, ever since we got here. Two police cars stationed in front. Now, the police are not saying why they're there. Nobody is apparently at the house of the suspect. Also, no one home at the home of the assistant principal. And there are a number of people in this neighborhood who have children who go to the high school or the middle school at Franklin Regional. Most of them were frankly too upset to talk about what happened today as they were retrieving their children or waiting for their kids to come home from school. We will have more on this, of course, later on, but for now, reporting from Murraysville, Paul Van Osdol, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.